Hey everybody, I'm Thomas, and this is Writtance, where we write whole worlds. Today I've got a story for you about a man attempting to make a pact with a being that exists beyond the boundaries of the material world. Sit back, relax, and enjoy the fantasy tale of The Pact. You know what you have to do. The headmaster of Arcanium Garantis stood behind me, barring my exit. I slowly turned to look at the planescape beyond the portal. Like a telescope adjusting its lenses, walls of vibrant colors were pulled aside as I gazed in its center, from red through yellow to green. Bit by bit, the spectrum expanded as the tunnel extended, but narrowed. I swallowed as sweat covered my brow. I see rock formations glistening with moisture? A cave? Unable to avert my eyes, I described the faint scenery at the end of the tunnel. Very well, and what else? The headmaster must have walked up close as I heard his voice directly behind me. A creature, I think. There's a shape. Darker than the shadows. Moving. Oh, it stopped. A sensation reminiscent of a spark of electricity ran through my spine. Is it looking at me? My pupils dilated the longer I stared, and the vibrant colors of the tunnels began to fade away. As time went by, I became unable to look at anything but the darkness of this being. In the far distance behind me, I heard his voice again, like a whisper in the wind. Do as you are taught. I slowly raised my hand and focused, pulling on a latent energy that ran deep within my core. Summoning the familiar sensation of intense heat, akin to the worst fever, I started the ritual. The air around my fingers began to spark and crackle in a familiar way. The friction of energy against the air broke the flow, creating small gusts of wind. With each motion of my dominant hand, the being's darkness began to open up. Fragments of cracked earth and stone compressed into a humanoid shape. Yet small and fragile looking, carried two glowing, yellow, pupilless eyes. Good. The whisper continued. Now, extend it. Intensifying my focus, the fever grew unbearable. The pressure on my brain forced me to squint as nausea and dizziness washed over me. Something popped in my ear, causing a painfully loud ringing noise to discombobulate me further. The crackling energy now generated enough wind to blow my hair backwards as I gestured for the being to draw closer. Still draped in darkness, the being stumbled forward on its short legs, its slightly larger head bobbing as it waddled. An intense wave of pain in my brain forced me to shut my left eye. Focus! The whisper said. Using all of my remaining willpower, I kept my remaining eye open as the being drew closer ever so slowly. When it finally stood in front of me, I stopped my gesture and instead extended my hand. I stumbled to one knee, the ringing noise now fully drowning out the whisper. With the last of my strength, I gave the being a smile. As I felt its rocky hand touch mine, I passed out and fell to the ground. When I opened my eyes, the scenery had changed. I found myself in the medical ward of Arcanium Garantis. I sat up in the bed as I looked around. The place was devoid of people, and based on the lack of light coming through, it was probably nighttime. In spite of this, I felt a wave of excitement, pride, and happiness wash over me. Drasna. As I whispered its name, a planar tear opened in front of me, and a familiar of stone emerged. From a glance, it wasn't much taller than 30 centimeters at best, and its comically large head bobbed from side to side as it gave me an inquisitive look with its yellow eyes. I couldn't help but smile. Nice to meet you, I said. I hope we will work well together in the future. The being waddled across my bed to where my upper body was and held up its rocky arm. I was confused for a second, looking at the fingerless hand. Oh! Realizing the gesture, I pulled my hand free from the blanket. and gave it a big high five. And that's it. I feel like it might make for a good personality test to see what kind of being a person would make a pact with. You know, if the summoner affinity of Arcana existed in the real world. Like the video if you like the video, and subscribe for more stories, worldbuilding, D&D, or fantasy-related stuff. If you enjoyed it, I got a lot more of these on my Instagram linked below. Thank you very much for watching, and I wish you a fantastic day. Take care, and see you next time. Bye-bye.